This episode of the Fratchelor is brought to you in part by Neil's Flowers and Gifts, open in Main Street in downtown Pullman, serving the local community for over 100 years. And by Star Sing Karaoke, open 1 p.m. to 2 a.m. 7 days a week on Grand Avenue in Pullman. For birthdays, parties, events, and more, come sing with us. Previously on the Fratchelor.
I'm excited, nervous. I have no idea who it's gonna be.
Oh my God.
And once more, Mason has a rebound, and the second effort is good. 18-4, and 8 points. What a night for Mason.
Nice. I was getting kind of worried with how competitive some girls were being. Like, Taylor, like, she was fierce out there, and I was like, I'm starting to take this personal, bro.
Kat and Mason, would you please step forward? Kat, would you like to go on a double date with me tonight?
Yes.
Mason, would you like to go on a double date with me tonight?
Yes.
Awesome, let's do it.
Back in the house, as things start to become clear, tempers flare.
Yeah, like, I wasn't even planning on seeing him that night. I literally just walked in and he was there. And I'm like, it's not like a game to me. Like, I want to find love at the end.
No, it's not a game to anyone.
You know, but it's like, at the same time, like, I sort of have to do what I have to do to try to get to the top here and do what it takes to win. Do what it takes to win. Do what it takes to win.
Ladies, Jake, final rose tonight. You don't receive your rose. Take your moments, say your goodbyes. Jake, when you're ready.
You wanna dance and kiss your way to the top? Sure, go for it. I just, like, that's just not how I'm about.
Episode 3 of The Fratchelor starts right now.
Ladies, Jake, it's the final rose tonight. If you don't receive your rose, take your moments, say your goodbyes. Jake, when you're ready.
Oh my God. Hi. Meet this fancy.
To Star Sync Karaoke. Isn't this room dope?
Yeah.
Good. Well, I'm excited you guys are here. I wanted to do something that got us a little bit out of our comfort zone and also to have some fun. So tonight, I am going to start by singing to all of you. Hopefully you guys like it, and let's have some fun. Hit it. You know a lot of girls be. This is not to get confused. This one's for you. Baby, you my head. You all I ever wanted. We can do it real big, bigger than you ever done it. You be up on anything. Other hoes ain't never on it. I want this forever. I said I can spend whatever. Shut it on you down. I when I get right on top, we're gonna be going with it. She made me beg for it. I say you the best I ever had. Just make sure that that's some special somebody. Young money. Yeah. You know who you are. I got you. So I hope you ladies love that. I have had a good time doing it. Tonight there's no specific assignment. You guys can do singles, you can do duets, you can do group singing. Let's have some fun and sing our hearts out. So I'm gonna leave the room and let you guys decide on how you guys are gonna sing. I'm looking forward to see what you guys come up with. Bye.
Well, there's been a little change of plans. Everybody welcome Sienna. She's going to be joining you for the rest of the season. Now, there's been a couple of things that have led up to this, but we won't get into that. I'll just let you know that she's here to stay for as long as this works out between her and Jake, and I hope that everyone in the room welcomes her just as much as you welcome everybody else when you all came to the house. I'm gonna leave you all to it. I hope you enjoy the rest of your night. I'll see you later.
Welcome. Thanks. Let's do this.
Woo! Woo!
Yeah.
Woo!
Thank you.
So can I actually talk to you outside for a little bit?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, I'm really engaged.
So, ooh. Okay, bye.
Interesting. How did that just happen? I haven't even had one-on-one, and she just swooped him in like freaking eagle.
Yeah, she just comes in here and thinks that she can steal him away.
I almost wonder if like they know each other from before or something.
Yeah, that's not
easy. Oh, that's so true.
You might be onto something.
Yeah.
So, why are you here?
Well, I've wanted to be here this whole time. It just didn't work out with, you know, scheduling conflicts.
Oh, okay.
So I'm just really happy that I get to be here now.
Well, I'm glad you're here. it's been fun so far. I'm glad that you're joining us now in the early stages. I'm looking forward to getting to know you more on a personal level.
Cool.
And having some fun. I hope tonight was a good time.
Yeah.
I kind of embarrassed myself a little bit, but
oh,
that's
same.
Okay. it was a good time. I had a lot of fun, a lot of laughs, and
yeah.
I hope there's more in the future.
Same. It makes me happy to hear you say that.
Thank you. So what brought you to the show?
Well, I've wanted to be here this whole time. It's just scheduling conflicts. You know, I just couldn't,
oh.
didn't work out.
Okay.
But I'm really happy to be here now. I'm happy that I still got this opportunity and to meet you. And
no, I'm glad to meet you too. And I'm
good.
Excited you're here,
good.
Starting on the journey with us in the early stages. And I'm looking forward to getting to know you more
cool.
on a personal level and having some laughs and having a good time.
Awesome. Well, I'm looking forward to that too.
So who's next?
Alright guys, I'm going to slow it down a little bit. Saucy. Saucy. So cute. I love it.
That was a blast. Did you guys have fun?
Yeah.
I embarrassed myself. I wasn't the best singer, but I hope you guys enjoyed it. I enjoyed listening to you guys sing and perform. But tonight, I'm gonna pick the one girl that I wanna go on a one-on-one date with. This girl really stood out during the performances, and I would really love to get to know her more on a personal level. So tonight, I will be picking that girl. Taylor? Would you like to go on a one-on-one date with me?
Of course.
So, Taylor, her and I were supposed to go on a date, but she got sick, unfortunately. So I'm gonna go get her something to lift her spirits a little bit, maybe a little coffee, a little roses.
And hopefully she starts feeling better. I hate being sick. So, yeah, go do this. Got Taylor some flowers and coffee. Hopefully she feels better. I heard she was sick, and I hate being sick, so I hope this will cheer her up. Flowers and coffee. Hopefully make her day feel a little bit better.
Hey, what are you doing here?
I heard you weren't feeling well, so I got you some flowers and coffee to cheer you up, hopefully.
Thank you. You're welcome. Do you want
to come
in?
Yeah. So, your weekend was just you were sick the whole time? You didn't go out or anything?
Yeah.
Not really eventful?
All my roommates are out of town right now, so it was just
weird. Really?
Yeah.
I went camping and my car broke down, and I was stuck on a mountain with no service and nowhere to go, and I thought I was going to die. And luckily, someone that was camping with us drove by and saved me. But I had to leave the car up there because
it's still there.
It's literally like sitting on a bluff, like hundreds of feet.
And it's still there. How are you gonna get it?
So I'm gonna drive all the way back, wait by the car, have AAA come get me, because they can't tow it unless you're there. Uh-huh. You have to be there. Huh. You can't just like be like, yo, can you go get my car? And bring it to Fytal.
Bring it back.
Yeah. So yeah, that's what I have to do tomorrow. So, when did you get mono?
Well, I went to the doctor, I think Wednesday.
And it's from sharing drinks?
Yes.
See, that's why I don't like to share
that's
drinks.
That's why I don't share drinks.
So are you feeling any better?
Not really, but this honestly, like, it made my day. It's a lot better.
Bringing it to you made my day, and I hope that you feel better, because being sick is not cool, and mono sounds horrible.
It's awful.
I don't know how long it lasts. I don't know what
literally
the contagious is.
It could be, like, months. So that's...
So you're going to be sick for months?
Yeah. I was literally sick for a year last year. So,
how did you?
I'm dying.
How did you live? How did you?
I don't.
How did you do life? Like, what did you? Did you stay in bed all the time?
Yeah, and I mean, like, I was in the dorm with my freshman year for a semester, and then I moved in here.
And then you probably got the frat flu when like you move in and you get instantly sick.
You're slim.
But then now my immune system's like invincible because like when you live in a frat, like
mine's just you know going straight down.
Now it's going down.
Yeah.
So yeah, I hope you feel better.
Thank you.
The flowers and the coffee made you feel better.
Thank you so much.
I hate being sick, and I hope that made your day. Because it made my day seeing you, so.
Nice to see you. Yeah, I'll walk you out. Okay. No,
should we put that in the shot?
Here's a composite.
Oh,
for you.
Thank you.
Here's your card.
I feel strong.
Bye. Emma, I feel like shit.
So, are you feeling any better?
Not really, but this honestly, like, it made my day. It's a lot better.
Bringing it to you made my day, and I hope that you feel better, because being sick is not cool, and mono sounds horrible.
It's awful.
I don't know how long it lasts. I don't know what
literally
the contagious is.
It could be, like, months, so that's...
So you're going to be sick for months?
Yeah. I was literally sick for a year last year, so
how did
sure
you?
I'm dying.
How did you live? How did you...
I don't.
How did you do life? Like, what did you stay in bed all the time?
Yeah, and I mean, like, I was in the dorm with my freshman year for a semester, and then I moved in here.
And then you probably got... I got the frat flu when, like, you move in and you get instantly sick.
You're slim.
But then now my immune system's, like, invincible because, like, when you live in a frat, like...
Mine's just
you know
gone
I mean?
Straight down.
Now it's going down?
Yeah. College just threw me
dirty. Yeah, when you share drinks all the time and stuff, like, mono will go around. So yeah, I hope you feel better.
Thank you.
The flowers and the coffee made you feel better.
Thank you so much.
I hate being sick, and I hope that made your day.
Thank you.
Because it made my day seeing you, so.
Nice to see you. Yeah, I'll walk you out. Okay.
Have a good
Nope.
Should we put that in the shot?
Here's a closet.
Oh,
for you.
Thank you.
Here's your party gift. When Jake came over this morning with the flowers and the latte, it was really unexpected, but it was super sweet. It made my day.
Hello, everyone.
Hi.
How's it going?
Good.
Well, it's now night 3, and things are starting to get a little more intense. How do we feel?
Good. It's been really good getting to like know each other and getting to know Jake a little bit more.
Yeah.
Does everybody feel good about why they're here?
Yeah.
Well, it doesn't get any easier from here, but for those of you that do stay, it does get more serious. With that said, why don't we bring him out? Jake?
Woo!
Hello, Jake.
Hi, ladies.
Hey, Jake.
Hi.
How are you guys doing?
Good.
You guys all look fantastic.
Thank you.
The other night, karaoke was my favorite night, honestly, and the reason why was because I was able to just be myself and act stupid around you guys, and it was kind of cute, maybe, I hope.
Maybe.
But you guys did great too, and that's why tonight's gonna be really hard, because you guys are all so amazing, and I felt like that night at karaoke, we really just clicked, and I felt like we all became like the homies, and I'm just like, I felt like as a collective group, we could all have fun and act stupid around each other, and it was non-judgmental, and it was just a good time. So it really loosened things up, and like I really enjoy hanging out with you guys, and that's why tonight's going to be really hard to say goodbye to a few of you. So tonight's going to be really tough because you guys are just all so great, and you know, it's hard to say goodbye to people that I've vibed with and had fun with, and you guys have seen me at my silliest, and hopefully you'll see me at my best. I'm getting better, so tonight's gonna be really tough. I haven't made up my mind yet. I'm gonna have to think about it a little bit. So I hope you guys are prepared, and I want to say cheers to the progress we've made so far and the fun that we've had so far as a group. Cheers to the journey and moving forward.
Cheers to that. Cheers.
So Emily, you look amazing tonight.
Thank you.
I just had a question for you. What are these?
Okay, these are my tarot cards.
Oh, that's what we talked about at karaoke.
Yeah, you're doing great. So they're like supposed to predict the future, but they don't really. Like,
Okay. They're
more of a reflection on your life right now. So if you're really going through things or you need to like think about life, kind of. I mean, a lot of people wake up every morning and just like read their tarot cards.
Oh, okay.
Just to like help reflect.
So is it kind of like a horoscope?
Okay. You're a Scorpio, which
yeah, Scorpio.
Actually, okay, so
I
don't
want to...
Is
that a good thing or a bad thing?
Well, okay, I haven't clicked with Scorpios in the past, but I think we're doing pretty good, right?
Good.
We're doing pretty good.
Totally.
Okay. But the bad part is that a Scorpio is represented by a...
The devil?
Yeah. Scorpios are like snakes. They shed their skin very easily, so you find it like very easy to change your personality kind of to fit what's
like
going
that.
On.
I like that.
You like it?
I like that, yeah.
Okay. So like... Each card represents something, and then the order in which you like pull the card reflects something too.
Oh, okay.
So I'm gonna shuffle it 3 times, and then you're gonna shuffle it 3 times.
Oh, yeah.
All right. And then while you're doing it, kind of think about where you are in life, kind of. So if you have maybe a problem that you can't solve right now.
There's a lot.
I mean, you're kind of picking, what are you doing right now? Yeah.
Yeah.
You kind of have a big problem right
exactly.
now. So just kind of like think about it. And yeah.
Okay. 3 times.
All right, here we go. So this first card reflects kind of, it reflects what's blocking you right now. So
that's what
I'm actually, okay, I'm going to do a love reading, like a love spread. Yeah, because I feel like that really reflects you right now. So
lay it on me.
This is the king of, okay, and then whenever I say anything, just like feel free to like, kind of connect it to your past, if you will.
Okay.
So this is the King of Cups, and it represents kind of communication. So in any of your past relationships, has communication been blocking you from like connecting, or maybe even like broken you up with somebody?
Yes, I would say it would seem like the answer would be lack of communication, right? Because that's
yeah.
usually the problem.
Mm-hmm.
But I think it's us not
both of us on each side, me and the girl that I'm dating, don't understand how to communicate how we really feel to each other the appropriate way. And that might cause arguments. So, like, that makes a difference.
So, this card represents what's in your past. So, this is... Okay.
Some sticks.
Yep, it's the 2, 4, 6, 8. It's the 8 of Wands, and so that kind of represents either the arrows of love, so maybe you've kind of felt a connection very recently in the past, I don't really know. And then also it can be the arrival of good news. So this card represents your future, and okay, that's kind of weird.
Why?
It represents perfection and unity, so...
So my G-Big, who's one of my best friends, he told me that you're his favorite on the show. And that means a lot. It's kind of like when you bring a girl home to mom and she's like, yeah, she approves.
Oh, yeah.
It's like that, honestly. So did you have fun at karaoke the other night?
It was the best experience.
Did I make a fool out of myself?
I think I was falling for you, so.
Your singing was stellar.
Thank you.
I loved it. It was really good. I wish I could sing. So how long have you been singing?
It's more of something I just did for fun growing up, you know?
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but, just for a good time.
That's what you do. You do it for fun. That's why you do
it. Yeah, exactly.
I don't know if we've talked about, like, your past relationship experience, but, like, talk to me about your past relationships.
Okay, yeah. So growing up, I've always been... very close with my mom. We have a very strong relationship, and I love my dad. But I've never actually been in a relationship.
Really?
Yeah. It's just, I have a lot of self-worth, and so to put myself in a position where a guy can, you know, get to know me, it's not something that I do, but I'm willing to let my walls down, you know?
And I think I honestly have the opposite problem, which I think could be a good match, because I sometimes don't give myself enough respect to say no to maybe a toxic relationship.
Okay.
I just kind of give my all to whoever it is. It's a little different for me, where it's like I'm more open to giving things a try, even maybe if it's with a girl that I know is not right for me.
Mm.
But I just give it a try anyways, because I'm like, you know, I'm just gonna do it. Where, like, you are more reserved, and I think I need to practice a little bit more of that. But I think a balance is important. Like,
yeah.
A little self-respect for yourself, to where it's like, I don't need to go out and mingle with everyone. And then there's other nights where it's like, I want to put myself out there a little bit and, like, get to know someone and have someone get to know me.
Yeah.
That makes sense.
I think we could balance each other.
I think we could. Since you don't usually do this, what are you potentially looking for in a relationship?
Yeah, honestly, just a healthy relationship, being able to be my goofy self around someone who's just as goofy, and just being able to be honest and communicate, really, and help each other grow. In the long run, I want to be able to grow into a better version of myself in the end. So.
You stole the world's words right out of my mouth. That's literally like the same kind of things, like make each other better. Be able to joke around with each other, understand, like, each other's tendencies, where you can kind of read each other.
Yeah.
Because the more you hang out with someone, the more it's easier to pick up on those kind of things. And I think that's what makes a relationship great, that dynamic where it's like, you know what they're thinking, and I know what I'm thinking, and you know what I'm thinking, and what we're feeling, and we can just, like, help each other grow.
Yeah, it can be a beautiful thing, really.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. Okay, I'm really glad I got to talk to you about this.
Yeah.
I think we both needed it.
No, definitely.
Yeah,
thank you.
Ladies, welcome to the second rose ceremony. I hope that this journey has treated you well so far, but not everybody's going to get the chance to continue. We have 7 roses here, and there are 11 of you. So 4 of you will not be continuing tonight. And I know it's tough, but it's just the way it is. Jake? Jake, tough decisions tonight. I know you make the right choice. Leave you to it.
Tonight is the second row ceremony. It's going to get harder and harder the farther we go in this journey. But I want you all to know that I've enjoyed all my time with all of you, especially our last date when we went to karaoke. I just felt like I could let my guard down and just be myself around all you guys. So tonight, I will be giving out 7 roses. Anna Maria. It's your 7 rose.
Absolutely. Thank you.
Katie. You accept this rose?
Yes.
Sarah? You accept this rose?
Of course. Thanks so much.
Taylor? You accept this rose?
Of course.
Emily? Do you accept these rose?
Yeah.
Mason? Do you accept this rose?
Yes.
Ladies, Jake, final rose tonight. If you don't get your rose, take a moment. Say your goodbyes. Jake, when you're ready.
Jess, Sienna, Megan, I'm sorry you did not receive a rose tonight. Take a moment, say your goodbyes.
Super pumped for what's ahead for us. It's gonna be even tougher to pick because you guys are so amazing. So let's get ready for some more dates. I want to get to know all of you more, and this is the perfect opportunity to do that. So congratulations.